Alrighty, Cade, here's your video lesson. I just want to let you know here that we are going to attach your raw hitting video so you can see it in totality. When you watch it, just look for, pitch location versus where you're hitting the ball, the flight of the path of the ball after it's hitted or after it's been hit. Just make reference to what you're doing with certain pitches, how many pitches you're hitting in the gap-to-gap area from 16 to 22% versus rolling over on or hitting low or hitting too high. Pay attention to that as you watch it. And also I'm going to load some of your pitching stuff in here so you can see that and get a jump on that. So when we dissect that later, you'll already have an understanding of your delivery here. So let's get into your action plan. Okay, so in general, after reviewing your swings here, you do have a lot of good stuff going on. You move the bat very well. You move your triangle very well. You seem to have loose hands and wrists. But there is a few points that I would bring up of areas that we can improve on. And to do so, I built a small little action plan for you to be able to work on this stuff, know where you're at, have a roadmap of where you're going with your swing, and some things to work on here. So as all of our swingers can, the master the snap drill is a big one. You do it pretty well, but I think it can be improved and get the bat on a little bit more downward plane. But again, that's important for early bat speed. It's something that you should, master, get really good at it, slow and methodically, and then speed it up without losing the technique. So that's something I want you to start practicing on as soon as you can. You don't do it too badly, but I think we can get more separation and load. When you step out with your left foot, you can keep your upper body and right shoulder back a little bit longer to create that rubber band, tension in the rubber band between the left hip and the right shoulder. The other thing that you're doing, not a ton, but enough to make it a concern of mine where we should probably look at why we're doing that and try to eliminate it on pitches, is full extension of the arms and getting to the power V. Certain times and certain pitches you do it just fine, and then other pitches you kind of roll your triangle through the zone without getting extended into your power V. So let's look at that situation, see how we can improve that, because without full extension you're not going to get proper bat whip, bat speed, and hit the ball as hard as you would otherwise. So you don't seem to cast your hands that often. That's awesome. You do maintain your 90 degree triangle integrity pretty well through your swing. Although on some swings, obviously the outside swings, you do it. So let's just visit what that is and how you can eliminate it completely or as much as possible based on the pitch. I think another thing to deal with casting in the snap drill is learning to attack certain pitches like outside high pitches in a different manner, coming through the zone with your hands. What comes to mind is the laser drill, where you pretend you have a laser attached directly to the end of the knob of your bat. Aimed in the same direction as the bat, and you take that to the ball and you split the ball. If you put that little caveat in your head and you then do some swinging, sometimes that'll change the position of your hands in the swing. So again, I just like to visit all that stuff here in your video and in the cages, and make sure you're well-rounded in that area. Next we've got grip aids, loose hands and loose wrists. I really like your hands and your wrists in the swing. It looks like your grip's okay. I haven't really looked at it up close. The only reason I bring this up is I don't believe you use pine tar, and a lot of people find that pine tar helps their swing because they can keep their hands looser, and especially through the pulling phase, it really helps keep the bat tight to the hands. And of course, the hands and the forearms are what controls the bat, so the looser that grip gets, the better the bat performs the way you want it to. So again, that's just to visit that with you and look at it and see if it can be improved at all. Right now, I wouldn't say there's anything wrong in that needs to be jumped out and fixed, but let's see if we can improve it. And then lastly, roll weight. All our players need to do this, but you know, the forearms, the wrists, the hands, the muscles in the hands, that's what controls your bat. The more strength you have in those, the better you're going to hit, the more power, the more control, more consistency going at the ball is going to improve. So I just want to make sure you're currently doing that and continue doing it throughout the winter into April and even beyond. But, you know, while we're trying to get our big jump and improvement in our swings here, I want to make sure that you devote time to doing that 3 times a week, 3 sets, as many as you can. So with that said, let's jump into your video. So here is a shot of you from what we're going to call down the line, attacking a low inside pitch. All in all, this is a really good swing. You put the ball on a little bit lower trajectory than you like, but this very well could be a base hit, you know, right by the shortstop, somewhere in that range. Maybe a little bit over his head, maybe right at him. But nonetheless, you didn't beat it into the ground. You didn't pop it up. And let's jump in a little bit further and dissect this thing. Okay, so we've got a low and inside pitch. It's over the inner half of the plate, just above the knees, lower thighs. There is the trajectory of it. So you can see the flight path of the batted ball. And ideally, we want to be able to have a swing that gets a little bit more loft on that ball. So let's take a look at your mechanics. Okay, so we start here at the step and load. You're loaded, turning on it. It looks like your hands come through on a pretty good path. You don't cast the bat or cast your hands. So the two things that are of note here is, one, the snap drill. Hopefully you've studied the video on that beforehand here, but you got a pretty good path to it. It you could get a little bit more of a downward or in a horizontal vertical swing, if you will, that would present the bat in a different area in the pitch. The second thing, let's take a look at your elbows. So there's your elbows. To this point in the swing, you have maintained your 90 degree triangle. Like so. So that all looks really good there. But here's where the lack of extension notations come in here. So you get to this point, you're just short of your power V, or where your power V should be. And instead, you keep your elbows sucked up to your torso. As you can see, you're still pretty bent there as you start getting into the follow-through. Okay. So you don't really get that full power V extension kind of situation going on that gives you maximum bat whip and exit velocity. Okay. So again, you only really do that on certain pitches. But we need to emphasize doing that on every pitch. In the practice setting where we got soft toss, front toss, not too high velocity, coach pitch, you know, BP, you should really be aiming for solid contact from gap to gap on the proper trajectory. So that's going to help build consistency come game time. So again, all in all, you've done real good with this pitch. I just like to see better extension, a more downward swing plane to get you through the inside. But you do everything really, really good. I think you're just off a tick in some of these areas, and they appear to be very simple improvements to be made. So it's probably just a matter of hopping in the cage and tweaking this, tweaking that, and trying it, and then you can probably roll out a new swing is my guess. So that's that. Okay, so let's take a look at this swing against some other players, get some different ideas of maybe how it looks for other swings and other players. Here we got you mocked up with Sawyer. Let's roll the tape. Okay. So you can see with a little bit more straight down type of trajectory and perfecting the snap drill, how the bat gets in position to hit that same pitch from gap to gap. This is going just left of the center fielder at a little bit higher trajectory, not probably, you know, 20 or 22%. Sawyer's is probably, I don't know, maybe 16%, give or take. But the direction of the bat, the extension of the hands and the arms, being an inside pitch, he's not maybe 100% fully extended either. So that does happen on inside pitches to a degree. There's a couple different ways to do it, and I'll show you how Aaron Judge does it on an inside pitch. But nonetheless, there's a different flight path and flight direction of the ball based on how downward or Ferris wheel versus merry-go-round your swing is. So you can just see those things. A couple of other things to point out here is when we're hitting, we really want to be strong and aggressive with throwing our shoulder back and over. Okay, so if we do the contrast here, we look at you, and you bring that shoulder back nicely. You really do. I'm just thinking you could probably plunge it back a little bit harder and really emphasize that. Just work on it and exaggerate it in batting practice. Overall, you're not really bad at all. But just something to think about, to add a little bit of power to your swing. And it does help you clear your hands and get extended as well when you do that a little bit more aggressively. So if you look at your guys at, if you look at yourselves at contact here, Sawyer looks to be just back a little bit further. If you look at that angle right there. You can see that Sawyer's a little steeper, which is part of getting your bat on a downward plane. So just a little side note there, the positioning of your shoulders. And it's hard to get into this position without the proper spine angle on the swing. So you come up a little bit taller, a little bit more straight here, and sort of a little bit more bent over this at this point. So it all has to do with the rotation of your body, so to speak. You're not really aggressively rotating all the way from right to left your torso in a swing. You're more throwing your left shoulder back, but if your spine angle's correct, you can come through the ball. It provides space for your hands and arms to come through down here, whereas you become more rotational the taller you get. So just some stuff to keep in mind. Again, you hit that ball really well. It's just a matter of looking for that extra percentage in attack angle and trajectory of ball flight. Okay, so here we got you synced up with Aaron Judge, and let's just roll these back and forth so you can look at both of them in slow motion. Okay, so again, we've got a pitch roughly in the same area. And you can see here that Aaron gets a little more trajectory on the ball, does pull it to left field. And if we erase our lines here, we can look at his extension and his power V. So that's Aaron's power V. You can see he's fully extended right there. He's gotten maximum power, bat whip, exit velocity off of this pitch. Okay. You can see right here he's just getting into his power V, but he's practically fully extended right there as well. You can see that he's very well maintained his triangle and his 90 degree separation of elbows as well. And let's take a look here at what some people call the laser drill. If you see as he's turning the triangle, the mental side of things at this point in time is he's thinking the knob of the bat, if it had a laser attached to it, pointing the same direction as the bat, as it is there. See that? At that point in the ball game, what you're trying to do to get all your body parts in the right position, but your hands, most importantly, is you want that laser coming off the end of your bat to slice right through the ball, okay? Once you attack a ball in that manner, you'll find that it's easier to keep your hands in front of your barrel till contact, which is a lot of times what you want. The good thing about people that swing their bat on the proper plane is you can hit it early or late in your swing, as long as it's on path, and you can do a good amount of damage either way. But as a practice routine, you want to try to hit the ball gap to gap or even middle only, and your barrel cannot be ahead of your hands to do that. If your barrel gets out ahead of your hands, you're going to pull the ball. So the laser drill is something that's really good. It's just a mental approach to put in your head as you're swinging to remember that. So, and then as we move Aaron's torso around, I want to point out right there, just watch his elbow, his arm, his shoulder, and his torso, and probably his back as well. Let's take a look. Yep, his back as well. So just look at this. This is all staying connected. It really, until about here, doesn't change in relationship angle-wise. He doesn't bring the arm out without the body. He doesn't bring the body out without the arm. The back is moving in relationship to the elbow. So like a lot of people say in the hitting business here, you swing. A lot of people describe this as swinging with your chest. I prefer the term swinging with your back, because in the end, what we're trying to achieve, and you'll see that Aaron does it really well, what you're trying to achieve is throwing that shoulder back while you're pushing upward here. And you get a sensation up here, okay, like you're falling off a cliff. Okay, you can see all the great power hitters have that type of a swing where they're really pulling back with the left shoulder and falling off the cliff. But I wanted to really emphasize the fact that all of this moves together, and you know, again, one good way to describe it is you swing with your back. Everything else stays the way it is until you get it flung out and get into your power V and get extended. So really want you to take a look at that. You see how his elbow is very stable right there, and he really doesn't change the relationship of that at all. You know, he does move into his power V and extend, but you can see the relationship, you know, of all that is roughly in the same position as when he started his swing. So that's why you'll see hitting instructors say, you know, you don't swing with your arms, you swing with your body, or you swing with your chest, or you swing with your back. And that's a very, very important element in the swing. So just wanted to illustrate that as well. Okay, so here's a different pitch, same view. And let's roll it. Let's see what we have here. We've got basically, it looks like a middle pitch. It's at the hips and it's the middle of the plate. And you hit it opposite field in the gap. at an awesome trajectory. So this is perfection right here, my friend. You get extended much better than you did on the last pitch. Okay. When I see a swing like this, this tells me that you're pretty good at the snap drill. And you're coming at the ball on a Ferris wheel plane versus a merry-go-round. Because if you are coming at this with a merry-go-round, you're not going to have that trajectory to the opposite field. Okay? So again, this is probably one of your best swings. Look at that again. So the only thing I would say about this swing here is remember the falling off the cliff sensation with your left shoulder. You get it back there so far that you feel like you're going to fall over backwards. Right there. You can see here that you still fall a little bit short. You know, right in there, everything breaks down. I'd like to see a harder pull further back with that left shoulder. Okay. It's going to give you probably a little bit more extension. You can see you didn't get 100% extended there. You can see that you've still got a little bend. You know, not every player always gets perfectly straight, but you got a little bit more bend there maybe than you should. So again, just falls back to that extension thing. As I said, you know, some pitches you do it more and less. Some pitches you do it less than others. Sometimes you do it more. Just something to be conscious about and see if we can get that happening full extension on more pitches. Let's take a look at how you're walking away from your hands, so to speak, your load. You can see you're doing it. Okay, your left foot's coming forward. You can still see there that you got a little bit of move backwards in your upper body, but in trying to improve your swing, I would like to see a little bit more twist with the upper body while the lower body is moving out. So just something to put in your mind, practice in the cage, see what you can make comfortable. Again, beautiful swing. Okay, so here's an outside pitch. Looks to be middle thigh, maybe a hair lower, outside edge of the plate. If you did that in a game, I would say that's pretty darn good. However, this is front toss at a very slow velocity. And attacking the ball with a little bit more downward angle, meaning perfecting the snap drill so the bat's coming through as a Ferris wheel and not a merry-go-round. And taking your hands to the ball just a little bit differently. Not too much different, but remember the laser, when you perfect that laser, and you can do that on every pitch off the end of the bat, I would say you'd get a little bit more trajectory and push it further to the right. Okay. Let's look at your extension. Not bad. See, on an outside pitch, you're going to get into your power V a little bit earlier. Your power V is going to be pointing upward a little bit more on an outside pitch. So again, not bad, but just something to think about, getting that snap drill perfected, a lower trajectory, rolling to the ball, Cutting the ball with the laser that's pointing off the knob of your bat. You're going to put that ball probably somewhere different and probably a little bit harder. So, FYI. So here we have Aaron Judge mocked up with you on your same swing we just analyzed. Let's roll this and you can see what he did with the pretty similar pitch. Okay. Okay, so here is this outside pitch, and let's take a look at some of the differences in the swing. So I want to concentrate at this point right in this area here. You can see as we roll this forward, right there, if you picture a laser coming off the end of his bat, it's essentially dissecting the ball, cutting the ball in half. That laser comes through the ball, the bat gets laid down, the hands are now being pulled forward, and he's taking this outside pitch at a higher trajectory over the fence in right field. If we erase these lines and look at this again, okay, he hasn't broken his wrists yet. He's almost to his power V. He still hasn't broken his wrists and turned his wrists over. Right there you can see his wrists are equal opposites, pointed right at each other. Right there, get a good look at that. And here he starts breaking his wrists after, or he starts during, but they roll over at the end of the power V. Okay? If we come back here, and roll this, you can see that right there your wrists are already rolled a little bit. Changing the dynamics of the power V. So I just want to get in the cage and now that you're aware of some of this stuff, kind of work on it. See if we can get some different actions, some different feels. The reason you're rolling over there is has a lot to do with the way you do the snap drill and attack the ball with your hands in that laser at the end of your bat. I mean, all in all, if you hit this pitch in a game, that sure looks like it's a base hit or close to it. It is a little bit lower trajectory, but it does look like it probably clears the second baseman, gets over the second baseman. Anybody in the stands and anybody in the dugout, including myself, would congratulate you for that hit. But again, our goal is to fine-tune all this stuff, give you as much knowledge about your swing and how your swing works, and shoot to get that ball on a, you know, 18 to 22 degree upward trajectory. So that's why it's best that we pay attention to these details and work on this stuff in practice. Okay, so that concludes the hitting. Let's put a few clips of your pitching up here for you to see. Now we'll sync you up with Abram for some comparison looks. Okay, so I'll attach your raw pitching and hitting video and finalize this and get it to the website for you.
I'm going to record.
Thank you.
move all balls over here, buddy. Same thing, okay?
Except if I'm going to haul it sometimes, point the camera to show one, two, or three. After I've been hit.
Okay.
Okay. Cade's doing really good.
Yeah,
Cade,
hold
it.
Hold
it.
Make sure
you
help here though.